Alright guys, back on this sleeve Gen 3 Coyote build. First thing we're going to do is check the piston pin clearance on these diamond MOD 2K pistons. These things are a neat piece if you haven't seen them. They got some really cool underbody structures there, or whatever you want to call them. And yeah, definitely nice pieces. They rate these at 2,000 horsepower, thus the MOD 2K in the name of them. So we're going to check piston pin clearances on that first, then we're going to check the small end of the connecting rod for pin clearance. We're going to get the pistons hung and slapped in the short block today. Alright guys, piston pin clearance on the piston side looks great. That typical spec is 0.8 to 1.2 thou at 68 degrees, which is how warm we keep this room, and everything was in within spec. So we're gonna pull the connecting rods out of the box, check the same tolerance on those guys, make sure those are okay before we hang the pistons. One thing that's often overlooked is connecting rod side clearance. Now, every manufacturer's gonna have their own spec. I think typical is minimum is 15 thou, maximum is 25. I've ran them looser without problems. But make sure you check it. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna untorque a couple of rods, throw some bearings on it, I'm gonna bolt them on a journal on the crankshaft, and I'm gonna check the side clearance with a feeler gauge currently. Alright guys, we got connecting rod side clearance checked. This particular setup came out to 18 thou. So we got that set. In the meantime, I also checked rod bearing vertical clearance, as you saw from the micrometer on the crankshaft and the dial bore gauge setup with the rod bearing torqued in the connecting rod. Now that that stuff's all good, we are going to go ahead and start hanging the pistons. I got all the rods untorqued and we've checked all of our clearances. So we are ready to hang the pistons and start putting them in the short block. All right guys, now that the pistons are all hung, we're ready to put them in the short block. So we got to put the oil ring supports on, which are these little, look like a piston ring thing if you're not familiar. They basically go in there to cover up the gap where the piston pin is recessed into the oil ring a little bit. This just supports the bottom of the oil ring, thus called an O-ring support. So we got to throw those on there. We're going to do that, put the oil rings on, and then I still have the piston rings in the cylinders we file fit for so they don't get mixed up. And I've got them backwards in the cylinder, meaning the top ring is on the bottom and the second ring is on the top in the order in which they go on the piston. So we'll pull one out and put it on there. And once we get the ring on the piston, we're going to clean each cylinder up. We're going to slap all these pistons in here, and that might be it for the day. I'm not sure yet. We'll see. We'll be right back. that's it for this one. We got the short block mostly together. The only other thing I would do normally is put the oil pump on it. I'm not gonna do just because that's all boxed up with the oil pan. I'm gonna leave that stuff together until we need it. But yeah, aside from that, it is done, it's together. If you're looking for more details on more in-depth stuff on piston pin clearances, I'll put a link in an end screen right here. You can check that out.